Okay, well, my character, Ted Wallace, is a failed and embittered poet who's a drunk, who has become a theatre critic, which he hates doing, and at the beginning of the film, he gets the sack. And he goes to... He gets employed by a kind of niece, really, who thought she was dying of leukemia, but thinks she's had a miraculous cure. And the cure happened at a country house called Swafford House, where an old friend of his lives, and one of his sons is Ted's godson. And she employs him to go and find out if the miracles are really true. And this is what he sets out to do, because he doesn't believe in miracles, and he sets out to prove they're wrong. And without giving too much away, I guess he learns something and to an extent gets his comeuppance.
We're working with a fantastic cast, particularly the young Emily Barrington, who is in many ways the catalyst for the story, and a wonderful young director. Can you talk, I guess, about specifically working with Emily and John?
Well, I'd never worked with Emily or John before. John had been wanting to get the film made for 10 years, so it's been a huge, long process for him, getting the script done and all that, and it's hugely to his credit that he persevered with it. Emily's just lovely. I mean, I didn't work with her a great deal, actually. We had, I think, a day together and just got on very well, and it was very, and had great fun. Well, it's great that a film can open, and by opening, it can do an event like this that supports two such great charities. I think that's wonderful.
I'm Dean Ridge, and I'm playing Simon Logan, the eldest brother. Simon is probably the only not weird one in the film, and he's the sensible one. It's the only way I can describe him. He's very practical, sometimes a little bit boring, especially in Ted's eyes, but that does play a fairly key role in the lunacy that happens at Swafford Hall. Whether he wants it to or not, that's another question entirely.
This is a film based on a wonderful book by Stephen Fry. Can you quantify what makes Stephen such a wonderful talent, specifically as a storyteller?
He is completely unafraid to use language in a colourful manner. I know it sounds very vague, but he has his own free form of language that I suppose he takes for granted as just speaking English. But to read it, I read the book a long time ago, and it's just a whole system of its own. And to hear, well, for example, his insults. The insults in the book and in the film just are a thing of beauty. Without being too crass or crude, they are just wonderful to listen to or to read. Well, I won't lie, it was 2 years ago when we filmed it, and this was the first big thing that I'd been in with other people, and to meet people like Roger and Fiona and Matthew and everyone. It was just, I was spoilt for choice particularly with the fantastic English actors. And someone like Roger, it is a masterclass to just sit next to him, which I'd not met him at all, and we had to do a scene where I'm driving him around in a very fast car and we hadn't really had an introduction, and just to hear that man wobble, shall I say, as we're speeding around was brilliant to be a part of, and to listen to a man that also has a fantastic command over the English language. And I think that's why he suits the character of Ted so well, is that he can not just say these words that are put in front of him, he makes them really, really quite something special, or venomous, depending on which side you want to look at it. Something very, very English, and not in the quaint Downton Abbey way either. It has the same beautiful settings, the same lovely plummy voices, and just a lot less serious. it's just something that only the English will appreciate. I mean, I hope a lot of people appreciate it, but it's very English sensibilities.
Hi, my name is Lynn Renee, and I play Valerie in The Hippopotamus. I think overall the audience can expect Stephen Fry at its best. The way how Robert Allen is basically bringing that storytelling, that specific storytelling that Stephen Fry is famous for, to the screen is something that, you know, when poetry becomes reality or when poetry becomes alive. I think Stephen Fry is, you know, becomes very special as a storyteller because of his honesty and his bluntness and his way of, you know, not having censorship and really writing down on paper what is need to be said in his mind. And I really love that. I think that's ballsy, and that's why I chose to do this film. Yeah, Valerie is an outside presence. She does come in and she basically represents the aristocracy from the French. And it was very, why I wanted to play this role is because there were so many opportunities for me to make that bigger and add a grandeur to it, which I did. It was so lovely to be able to do comedy slash drama. I'm not going to really say that it was just pure comedy, but to be able to slip into Valerie was just, was a lot of fun. It really was. Yeah, working with Roger was an absolute treat. You know, I think he's a poet on by himself. He's got such a beautiful way to bring language and storytelling to the screen. It's like he's analyzed every single word and he's so precise in bringing that. And I think it's just wonderful to see someone and inspiring who works like that, and to work alongside them was just, for me, I've learned a lot, I have to say.
Hi, my name is John Jenks and I'm the director of the Hippopotamus. I've really fell in love with the book of the Hippopotamus when I first read it. It's incredibly funny, it's joyous, it has a great detective plot that runs through it that keeps you engaged and ticking along. But then it also has that sort of wonderful humanity that Stephen's really known for, that ability to really engage with this sort of individual within inside you, despite the pomposity, despite all the language, despite all that boldness. The book is really about kindness, and I think kindness is such an important and underdeveloped quality. You know, we kind of put kindness down because, oh, you know, it seems sort of childish, but actually if you're not kind and we don't treat each other with kindness, society and culture really fall apart. And that's the point I wanted to get across in the film. And I think that's, you know, being as true to Stephen Fry's essence as I can be. So it's only ever been Roger. For the Hippopotamus, the character of Ted Wallace always had to be Roger. We spent a lot of time to finance the film, and we'd go into meetings and people would say, yeah, we see that Roger's great, but could you put Hugh Grant in a fat suit? And we'd sort of say, no, it's got to be Roger. It's just got to be Roger. And if you can't get that, we need to work with other people. And we stuck to that. And, you know, Roger is the only actor I can think of who could be as dangerous as Ted is and sort of unnerving as he is in lots of points of the film, but could also deliver Ted's wonderful lines with the sort of clarity and consideration that he does, but then also know that despite his pomposity and his aggressiveness with other people, that the person he hates the most is himself. And that sort of vulnerability and causticness that, you know, aimed at himself, I think is something that really only would have worked with Roger as the lead. Emily is our sort of, she gets the script going, she gets the film, she's the engine behind everything that happens. We spend a lot of time talking about how she was in that sort of state of complete conviction and true belief, and she was sort of focused on getting things done, and she had to have a sort of complete innocence to her, as well as a real sort of off-the-wall craziness, and being able to pull those two things together as a balance was a really important part of the film. I'm really happy to be showing the film tonight, right in the middle of central London, and I wanted to put together a screening for Maggies and Blue, because they're two causes that I really believe in. Maggies was started by my parents in the mid-90s after my mother passed away from cancer. My mother was Maggie. And the Blue Marine Foundation is a cause that I've always wanted to... I wanted really to be able to share my love of fish and the sea with my children. So Maggie's is something I've inherited from my parents, and Blue is a charity that I want to share with my children.